I'm Steven Facchino, Engineering Construction Manager for Mortar Net Solutions. Today I'd like to show you how to install rubberized asphalt TotalFlash. But before we begin, I'd like to explain a little bit about what TotalFlash is. TotalFlash is a 5-foot membrane that comes with a stainless steel drip edge, weep tabs, a drainage mesh, the built-in termination bar, and then the lap is always built into every panel. What we're going to talk about today, what makes rubberized asphalt TotalFlash a little different, is there's a release paper on the back side of the rubberized asphalt. Well, when you release it and you pull it back, it gets sticky. We're going to show you what part of the release paper you need to release and remove, where to put the sealants, and how to get a good overall installation. So let's go ahead and get started. Okay, before we install any of our TotalFlash products, it's important to get our corners waterproof properly. What we're going to begin with is a preformed stainless steel drip corner. I put one bead of polyether sealant on the brick shelf, make sure water doesn't migrate up underneath it. After that, I put my preformed 14-inch corner boot in place. I put a bead of sealant all the way around the very edge of the perimeter of this boot. That way, when I put it in place, it oozed out, ensuring that I had a good seal and a watertight connection between the substrate and the boot. We use the MPE1 polyether sealant, formulated just for our products, to make sure you get good adhesion on every project you do. Once you've established the corner boot and the drip, you're ready to begin. Now, the panels come in 5-foot lengths. We're using a shorter panel because this is for demonstration only. First thing I'm going to do is go ahead and put a bead of sealant down on the brick ledge. Now that we have the bead of sealant on the brick ledge, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and place the panel. The back side of the panel has a release paper on it. We really only need to release the paper to that point before we slip it on the wall. Okay, what you want to do is before we set it down, we want to make sure our drip edge and our stainless steel corner line up exactly correct and press it down. We're going to maintain the release paper on the rubberized asphalt at this point. I'm going to go ahead and dry fit it into the wall to make sure it's going to give me a good fit. But I'm also going to, at that point, line up where my holes are going to be drilled, my pilot holes are going to be drilled prior to putting my anchors in. If I leave the release paper on the adhesive and drill my pilot holes, the dust doesn't ruin the adhesive. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull the release paper that needs to be pulled so that I can go ahead and finish up this installation. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come back here and I'm going to fold the release paper up underneath and go ahead and set this down into place. Okay, I went ahead and removed just a little bit of release paper from behind the turn bar. The gasket that you create with the sealant works as a way to make sure that any water that comes down that wall is shed over the turn bar and directly onto the flashing. What I do, because I don't like sealant all over my tools and all over myself, I go ahead and pre-drill the pilot holes, make sure that my screws are going to line up perfectly once I go ahead and place the material. I go ahead and put the sealant on the tip of the back of the turn bar so that when I compress it, it oozes up and I can strike it and I don't have to put a second bead of sealant down. So let's go give it a try. Now, one of the tips when you're doing your screws on your turn bar, I use a PVC turn bar 90% of the time with all the things I recommend. I don't like to tighten these things down so tight that it creates a bow in the turn bar. With the sealant in behind, the gasket's formed. This is a mechanical attachment for your flashing, so you don't have to worry about the adhesive on the rubberized asphalt ever failing. That's why, because we have a turn bar, we can leave part of the release paper in place. We pulled the release paper here and we have a good seam here. And then at this point, you just come through and you just slick it just so you have a good bead of sealant right over on top of your turn bar. And any moisture that comes down is going to bridge right over onto your flashing. And that's the whole point of it. We're at the other side of our lap now. We're getting ready to do the lap. We get a lot of questions. With rubberized asphalt, does this part need to be adhered down to the substrate? Well, for the time it takes to pull the release paper, it's not worth not doing. So I'm going to show you how to do it. Basically, just grab it, take your release paper, and tuck it up underneath. You have a good seam, and then you'd go ahead and get ready for your next turn bar. Take the release paper on this one. Okay, we maintained our release paper while we did our pilot holes. Now I'm going to go ahead and show you. You can just take it and fold it out of the way, or you can take your knife and just cut it off. Once we go ahead and get this completely into place, put our bead of sealant on the back of the turn bar. All right, guys, what we've got here is we've got rubberized asphalt. We showed you how to do a lap. We showed you how to pull the release paper. Pulling the release paper and folding it under is your option, or you can cut it. But the full release paper does not need to come off when you install rubberized asphalt, as long as you're using the termination bar. Your turn bars don't need to line up perfectly. If they're a little in and out, that's fine. The other thing, do not tighten down your anchors or your screws that hold your turn bar too tight. You want to make sure they're snug, and that's it. If you have any questions, you're always welcome to give me a call. I'm Stephen Facchino. Thanks for watching.